Zaila, welcome to NASA. The Artemis missions are going to bring the first woman and the first person of color to the moon. And in honor of those missions to come, my word for you is apogee. Apogee is the point in the orbit of the moon or another satellite object where it is farthest from the Earth. Apogee.
I can tell you right off the bat, I know that one. Apogee is A-P-O-G-E-E.
Hi Zaila, I'm Yolanda, and my word for you is eutrophication. Eutrophication is a process of excessive plant growth in a body of water that is frequently due to runoff from land. The dense growth of plant life, usually phytoplankton, at the surface can lead to death of plants below that are unable to photosynthesize, and therefore the death of animal life from lack of oxygen. Eutrophication.
Eutrophication. E-U-T-R-O-P-H-I-C-A-T-I-O-N.
My word for you to spell is parsimony. Parsimony is the scientific concept that the simplest explanation to fit the data, or the explanation with the fewest assumptions, is most likely the best explanation. Parsimony.
Parsimony. P-A-R-S-I-M-O-N-Y.
Hello, Zaila. My word for you to spell is centrifugation. Centrifugation is the process of using rotating force to separate particles according to their density. For example, this concept is how a washing machine gets excess water out of clothing during the spin cycle. Centrifugation.
Centrifugation. C-E-N-T-R-I-F-U-G-A-T-I-O-N.
Hi, Zaila. I am Jessica Meir, and I'm one of the NASA astronauts on the Artemis team. Having a long-term presence on the moon will prepare us for sending astronauts further into our solar system in the future. Since you are such an incredible spelling star, my word for you is aphelion. Aphelion is defined as the point in the orbit of a planet or another celestial body where it is farthest away from the sun, the star of our solar system. Aphelion.
Aphelion. A-P-H-E-L-I-O-N. Try dribbling 3 basketballs at once like this.
But I'll give it a shot. Here we go. Here's 3. Stop. Thanks for the challenge, Zaila. This has been fun. To everyone watching today, I challenge you to look at stem.nasa.gov and take advantage of all of the educational and outreach opportunities we have for you. Happy exploring!